Well, hello and a very warm welcome to you wherever you are in the world. It's great to have you with us. And of course, we're in Chengdu, China. It is now Kyorugi time, the fighting time. As you can see, the women's under 46 kilogram final, Rita Bakisheva against Wang Yinshuan. Well, a nod from both fighters. A cheer from the fans in the Wangjiang Arena. Whoever takes this round will take the title. A little front leg flick to the body there from Wang. No scores on the board. Bakisheva almost getting one up to the head there. There's a sensor on the socks and on the helmet. So if you hit that, you get 3 points. If you hit the body with good power, you'll get 2. If you spin, you get another couple of points added as well because it's more difficult. Jaiyo, the call from the crowd. They want this one to get moving. They know that gold's at stake. Bakisheva in blue, leaning back. Neither fighter committing. Halfway through now. This is the final round. There's the push kick to the body. Rita Bakisheva backs up her efforts in Baku. Was she pushed over or is it a straight gam jump? It is a gam jump. That's the penalty. That will be 2-1 now. The score's on the board. The front leg of Rita Bakisheva. Into the latter stages of this one we go. 2-1. Just about 30 seconds to go in this one. Apologies, we've lost the scoreboard in the top left-hand side of your screen. Bakisheva battling forward, back right turning kick, almost scores. The clock ticks down, we've got the scoreboard back, 20 to go. It's a nice front leg counter hook there. Rita Bakisheva in blue is winning 4-1. Into the last 10 seconds we go. Wang coming forward for Chinese Taipei. She walks into a head kick. It's an excellent kick to the face there. The gam jump will be given that will cut it to 4-2. There is 5 seconds left. However, a real legitimate kick to the face there from Rita Bakisheva. And I think the Chinese Taipei coach saying the kick to the head was done off the mats. Here we go. Flick to the face there. Good shot. And lands out. So kicks, scores when she's on the mat. Lands out of the mat, so that should be a legitimate three-pointer. Yeah, successful three for Kazakhstan. And by virtue of that, it will be unsuccessful for Red, who were looking for that penalty point. Worth a throw from Chinese Taipei team. Wang Yinshuan. Now, with a lot of work to do and no time in which to do it, Rita Bakisheva will be backing off. Is she going back with a gold medal to Kazakhstan? For all the will in the world, it looks like it. 5 seconds to go. 7-2, the score's on the board. There's the front leg to the face counter again. Excellent stuff from Rita Bakisheva. Good credit, Wang Yinshuan. Tried to go for the win with the spin. Walked into the kick in the face. And Rita Bakisheva, well, she battled to quarterfinals in Baku at the World Championships. She's battling towards an excellent gold medal here. And the coach, quite right too, looking for every point available. There was an excellent front leg to the face from Rita Bakisheva. Like so, there. And that would be another 3 points. And when the record books are added up, the points make prizes. And the prize in question will be the title of FISU World University Games champion. Bakisheva doing the business here in Chengdu. 10-2, and that will do for Rita Bakisheva from Kazakhstan. the Kazakh Academy Sport and Tourism. She graduates with honours, flies the flag, and is chased off the mat there by the volunteers. Well, wonderful moments for the under 46 kilogram finals. Confirmation, Minaya Akbarova from Azerbaijan with bronze. Likewise, Zhai Huting of China. Huang Yingxuan, excellent silver medal in the final. But Rita Bakasheva, back in business and back on the top of the podium. Fisu's fantastic four in the 46s. Confirmation then. Gold for Kazakhstan. Now time for the men's under 54 kilogram final at the Taekwondo. Uzbekistan against Iran. And it's Omerjon Otajonov against Madi Hajimusain. And off we go again. There's a big kick to the face. Hubam, indeed, the call. Good stuff. Push kick to the body will do. So for Iran, you can see the Iranian flag. You can see one, which means he's got one round. And you can also see three, which means he scored a head kick. Trying to score a little body kick in the inside. Good strength there from Otajonov. The Uzbek going with the spinning kick. That would be worth four to the body or five to the head. But ahead at the moment, Iran's finest. In the close stance as we go into the closing stages, 1 minute left. Punch lands, but did the upper arm slide down off the protector? Yep, a nod there from Madi Hajimusain. He'll be checking on his opponent. Let's have a look here. So we're watching the front arm, punches the butt. No, it did actually hit the nose first. Good work from the video review team there. There was no intention there. The Gamjon's been given. The scores on the board. Backlight turning kick from Otajonov, the man in blue, trying for the spin. He looks determined, gets a nice turning kick in the inside, doesn't score. 45 to go. Well, a real fight has broken out here. Omerjon Otajonov in the World Championship bronze medal battle in Baku, fought just like this, coming forward like a train. But still on track as the man from Iran lands a cracker to the head. Madi Hajimusain, can he see the gold medal in the distance? Second Gamjon, five of those, you'll lose the round. But not losing focus, he might take another Gamjon here for holding. Referee lets it flow. 20 to go. Up on his toes, Madi Hajimusain from the Azad University does well to avoid the spin kick. Good credit, Omerjon Otajonov, trying with the spin. Good push kick, that's the way you want to finish a final. Madi Hajimusain stamps his authority. Didn't get a score, but creates a penalty. 8-point game. Just about the same amount of seconds left, and the referee will give another penalty to the Iranian. However, in a matter of moments, they'll be giving him a gold medal as well. Omerjon Otajonov from Uzbekistan will take the silver medal. But this man here, what a performance! Madi Hajimusain, elation and emotion for the World University Games champion. An apology there for that punch to the nose, didn't mean it. And Omerjon Otajonov sinks to his knees. Show of respect there for the young man from Uzbekistan, the National University student. He did himself proud. But the pride of Iran, Azad University's finest, Madi Hajimusain, takes the gold. Sarwat Mohammed of Thailand with bronze. Likewise, Nam Yong-hyuk of Korea. Silver goes to Omerjon Otajonov. And Madi Hajimusaini with the gold for Iran. Shahad Bosh to the young man from Tehran. And that will be a wonderful moment for him and his friends and family. The women's under 57 kilogram final. It's Chinese Taipei's Lo Chai Ling against Kim Yujin. the Korean battler, and what a fighter she is as well. Tangled up in Blue there in the centre, but getting her lines right so far, the Korean, as she strides around in red. Good little front hand punch there, walks into front leg counter though. As Lo Chai Ling gets herself 2 points down with a minute to go. Good front leg again there, Kim Yoo-jin. The front leg, of course, the leg closest to the fighter. Back leg, well, you can guess which one that is. Back leg almost. Back in business there, the Korean stepping out. She'll take a penalty for that. And that'll make it 4 points to three. If you lose five of those, there's a great head kick though. Excellent stuff. Kim Yoo-jin, possibly for the win. World University Games gold medal at stake. This is the first round, one of two. Lo Chai Ling still in this contest. She's the fighter in blue. The Korean coach saying, Aurgo Joshime, watch out for the head kick. Good advice, because Chinese Taipei's Lo Chai Ling will have to go high. Clock ticks down, lovely front kick. Kim Yoo-jin lands it on the protector, and she's going to land that first round there, showing her strength. There was an excellent front leg to the face. The Wangjiang campus, Sichuan University, they would love for the Chinese Taipei fighter Lo Chai Ling to get on the board. You can see a little one next to the Korean flag. That means she's won the first round. Halfway to gold. Kim Yoo-jin of Korea, excellent in that opening round, very strong in the centre, using the front leg to good effect. Back leg turning kick there, just to vary things up. And I think leaving a space there, perhaps for a little flick up stairs. Yep, that's the signal from the Chinese Taipei coach. So that back leg turning kick, thrown by Kim Yoo-jin, did it leave a space for a kick to the face? Let's have a look here. Back leg turning kick, and there's the flick. Well, could be. She signals to her coach. Coach just responding there to Lo Chai Ling's request. She's looking for a possible kick to the face from blue to red. Critical times now. Thumbs up indeed. 3 points did score. Card stays. Kim Yoo-jin, understandably and predictably, comes straight out. Kick to the body, makes it 3-2. 2 points for kick into the body, 1 point for any penalty, which is for falling over or running away, but no signs of that from Lo Chai Ling. Kim Yoo-jin up on her toes, back kick tried there from the Korean, left the space, almost took one to the face. Speaking of the Gamjoms, does well to avoid the penalty. Half a minute. Lo Chai Ling needed exactly this type of round. There's still half a minute though for the Korean in red to fight back. Takes her time, goes with the punch in the inside. Good defence though from the fighter in blue. Are we going to a third and decisive final round? There's the score though from Kim Yoo-jin. Scores the body kick. That could be the gold medal, or can it be the Gamjong created? It is. The penalty that I mentioned gives for the push. Good refereeing, that makes it a 2 point game. However, the Chinese Taipei coach is going to contest that, quite right. It looked like a double handed straight out push off the mat. This is what we're looking at. Push kick, is it a double handed push there and out? Well, that's what the referee saw. If that is the case, it will stay at 5-3. If it's not the case, oh, we're going to have a 1 point game. What does Yang Jin Lee think? Yeah, she agrees with the centre ref. Good decision. Worth a throw from the coach. 5-3 game. Kim Yoo-jin makes it 7-3, and she's going to make it on top of the podium. She'll take the gam jump, which is the penalty, and it will be 7-4. The scores on the board. Well, Yoo-jin from Korea. Excellent stuff. Lo Chai-ling from Chinese Taipei will take the silver. But Kim Yoo-jin is now Kim Yoo-win. Congratulations to her. The World University Games champion. Doing it in style. There's confirmation. Paditra Jankovic of Poland with bronze. Likewise, Yang Yunli of China. Silver to Lo Chai-ling. The gold medal goes to Kim Yoo-jin. Time now for the men's under 68 kilogram final between Yi Sang-rul and Chu Yi-ju from Chinese Taipei. And Yi-ju in red. Sang-rul, of course, in blue, trying to battle through there, the Korean. Serge Simbon, the French centre referee, keeping an eye on proceedings. Back kick there, excellent stuff. That will be a four-pointer. And Serge Simbon quick to react. An excellent jump-up back kick. He's been doing it all day as Yi Sang-rul hitting the high notes with the Dui Chagi, the back kick. And Sang on song for Sang-rul. Chi Yoo-ju, what can the man in red do to respond? Twisting kick. Is he in with a shout of getting back into this? Wonderful control of distance though from the Korean in blue. Balletic jumps through, pretending to punch. Almost going with a little push kick to the body. Good adaptation, confidence high. Oh, speaking of high, there's a headshot. Textbook technique plus the two-pointer. 11 to the good. And he's been too good for everyone today. And I think the Chinese Taipei coach is going to play a video review card to have the protector system tested. So we haven't seen that. Yeah, so just to make sure that the sensors, well, this is a good chance to see them. Sensors on the socks, kicking to the body. And it works cleanly. Good call from the coach. He wants to have the head guard tested as well. And Yi Sang-rul doing it for them. And of course, you're not allowed to do that. So the dado system just getting checked here. There's the head guard being kicked, and it works perfectly. So good call from the coach. It's not the system. It's the skill of the man in blue. He stayed out of the way. 11 points up, and he's going to be one round up as well. And if there's going to be a highlight round up, there's been some good head kicks from the man in blue. Nice spin step away there from the Korean, controlling the distance, controlling the narrative as well. And when they etch the history books of this one, it's going to say one round to the good. Credit Chi Yoo-ju for fighting to the finish. Creates a gam jump. 11 point game becomes 10. Oh, excellent stuff there on the inside. Well, better from Yoo-ju as he goes back to his coach. He's the fighter in red. Manages to get a score on the board in the last seconds there. But this young man here, imperious and very impressive. Well, textbook taekwondo from Yi Sang-rul, jumping back kick, that four-pointer, absolutely perfect. And this one not bad either. The Korean in blue is Yi Sang-rul. He's one round up. If you look up at the top of the screen next to the Korean flag, there's a little one next to that. If he can make it two, it'll be gold for him. However, Chu Yi-ju, he's in red, trying to fight back into it. Felt the skills and I think the strength of the Korean in the first round. And the young man from Yongin University, full of confidence, now step through punch. Well, I liked it. Judges not so much in that one. Open stance, trying to draw the back leg in from the Chinese Taipei fighter. That was the reason, wanted that back kick again. And there's a fair chance that he might change it to a reverse turning kick, the spin up the stairs. But spinning things round though. Yi Ju from Chinese Taipei. The credit where it is due. One up. Oh, big head kick attempted there. Good evasive movement from the man in blue. Gets out of the road. There's just a call to the referee there. The corner judges stood up in unison. They're giving that 1 point for the punch, I believe. So it's tied up at one all. There's a little green light on in favour of the man in blue, which means he's got more touches to the protector. Good push though. Chi Yuji trying to come forward. Good front leg counter from the man in red. Good double. On the double he is. Half a minute to go. Judges like that punch. That could be the one that seals the gold. Big punch again, aggressive. Makes it a 2 point game with every two game. Good work again. Gets his head out of the way. Will he have a medal round his neck at the end of it? Will it be gold? The Korean turns his back though. There was the reverse turning kick that I mentioned. But he'll be taking a gamjom for avoiding before that. 1 point game. Will it be gold for Korea? Yi Sang-rol up on his toes, back right turning kick there. Chi Yuju, good push from the Korean, and that will push him up onto the podium. He shimmies, he shuffles, and he shows his skill and class. The young man from Yongin University, Yi Sang-rol, hitting the high notes here in Chengdu, making dreams come true indeed. He's the champion. Congratulations, Yi Sang-rol. Likewise, silver for Chi Yu Ju. And the young man from the National Sport University in Chinese Taipei did well, but so, so good was Yi Sang-rol. Ferhat Kavarat of Turkey with bronze. Likewise, Zhao Shenming of China. Chu Yi Ju of Chinese Taipei with the silver. And it's Yi Sang-rol on top of the world. Congratulations to him, the World University Games champion, Yi Sang-rol.